gospel shoes of peace. Take up the shield of faith, helmet of salvation, and the sword of the Spirit. Be strong in the Lord and in His mighty power. Put on the full armor, armor of God, so you can take your stand. Gospel shoes of peace. Take up the shield of faith, helmet of salvation, and the sword of the Spirit. Be strong in the Lord and in His mighty power. Put on the full armor, armor of God, so you can take your stand.
Lesson on the armor of God. Today I'd like to begin by reading verses 13 to 16 of our epic Bible passage, Ephesians 6. Why don't you read it with me? It says, "Therefore take up the whole armor of God, that you may be able to withstand in the evil day, and having done all, to stand firm. Stand therefore, having fastened on the belt of truth, and having put on the breastplate of righteousness, and as shoes for your feet, having put on the readiness given by the gospel of peace. In all circumstances, take up the shield of faith, with which you can extinguish all the flaming darts of the evil one." What is the fourth piece of God's armor? It's the shield of faith, that's right. I would like to now take a few moments to help you understand why you, as a follower of Jesus, need a shield of faith. First, we're going to use three words to help us understand why a shield is important armor to put on. First, a shield identifies who you are. If you look at the three shields in front of you, you'll see each one has a crest or a logo on them to identify who this shield might belong to. Which shield do you think belongs to Captain America? Well, that's pretty obvious. It's the one with the star, because that's the logo that represents Captain America. Which one do you think belongs to a Christian? Yes, of course, it's the one with the cross on it and the word faith that represents a Christian. And so then, by process of elimination, of course, the last one is a Roman shield. The crest you see on that and the colors of red, yellow, and some white as well, I can see there, represent the Roman logo. So a shield identifies who you are. Second, a shield protects. Okay? Even after putting on the other pieces of armor, we still need to put a shield in our hand for extra protection. On its own, a Roman soldier's shield was quite large and probably would have come up to around the shoulders of each soldier when holding it alone. Each shield would have been made of some type of metal, and on top of that, they even sometimes added animal skin or coated it with water so that if fiery darts came at them, the wet shield would put out the fire. Roman soldiers were smart too, and they didn't just use their personal shields alone. They knew enough that there was extra protection when they banded or joined together with other soldiers in the army. If you look at the bottom picture in the middle, you can see a group of soldiers banded together. This was a formation called a testudo. The third word I want to remind you, or to help you understand why we need a shield, is the word moves. Why do we need a shield? Because a shield can move. It is a piece of armor that helps you because you can move it around. When you have it in your hand, you can move it to all sides and all directions to provide extra safety and extra protection, no matter where you put it. In order to defeat the enemy, soldiers need to be able to move towards their enemy, not just stand still and protect themselves from what the enemy is sending their way. You can see in both pictures under the word moves that you can see some Roman soldiers as they move toward their enemy. Now that you understand how a shield by itself can help you, I want to help you understand why it is described as a shield of faith. What's that word faith add to it? First, what you say and what you do should identify you as a follower of Jesus. If you are following Jesus, you are also called a Christian. And we can say that you have chosen to put your faith in Jesus Christ. You have chosen Jesus to be your friend forever, and you are trying to live a life obedient to God. When you do that, you are showing others that your identity is with God. Second, your shield of faith protects you because you know to do three things. One, you know to pray. You know to pray and seek God's protection and wisdom every day. You know every situation you go into to look to the Lord and ask for His wisdom. Ask Him how to make the choices and decisions that need to be made, especially when faced with a tough situation. You know to read God's Word, and you know that memorizing Scripture, having it in your heart, is what's going to help you when in a moment of a tough situation and you don't know what to do. Well, God's Word, God through the power of the Holy Spirit, is going to make His Word speak to you at that very moment. You know your faith protects you when you choose godly friends. When you have made the choice to be a Christian, you need the encouragement and friendship of other Christians. Just like Roman soldiers sought extra protection by forming the testudo, you receive extra protection when you gather together with other followers of Jesus. Their support is what's going to help you keep focused on the Word of God, and it encourages you to keep being obedient in your daily walk with God. This isn't to say you can't or shouldn't have non-Christian friends, though, because remember, We do need to share the good news with those who don't know or understand what it means to have Jesus in her as their friend forever. It simply means you need to be careful that you have no Christian friends. Finally, your shield of faith allows you to move forward or grow in your relationship with God. Once we make a choice to have Jesus as our forever friend, or we make the choice to become followers of Jesus, we are not done getting to know God. We need to keep working at our relationship with Him. This means we need to keep talking to Him. We need to pray. And we need to keep allowing Him to talk to us. We need to read and understand His word. We also need to tell others the good news. And we had talked about that last week in our lesson. Of course, the devil does not want us to do any of this. So he's going to try to stop us. He's going to try shooting his fiery darts at us. Those are his lies and tricks to make us stop believing in what God says. But if we hold up our shield of faith, the lies are not going to touch us at all. We are going to keep growing closer to God. I want to now take a look at a story from the Bible, a time when some followers of Jesus forgot to hold up their shields of faith. You can read the story in Mark 4, verses 38 to 40, or Matthew 8, verses 23 to 27. I do hope you'll take the time to read it word for word later on, but for now, let's watch this video clip to see how Jesus' disciples, in a moment of crisis, forgot to hold up their shield of faith.
Even though you can't see it, there's a spiritual battle taking place between God and the devil over the hearts of each person on earth. Since the beginning of time, God has been fighting for people to know who He is and how much He loves them. You would think that followers of Jesus would never doubt that Jesus could do anything, but that's actually a part of the battle. Jesus healed many people and showed them many examples of God's power. One evening, Jesus asked His followers to go with Him across the lake. So they left the crowds of people they'd been helping and went with Jesus. As they were on the water, the winds grew stronger and the waves started coming up over the sides of the boat, filling it with water. When Jesus was inside the boat, sleeping with His head on a pillow, His followers came to find Him. They woke Him up and asked Jesus if He even cared about them. They were afraid He was going to let them drown. Jesus got up and gave a command to the wind and the water. He told the storm to be still. Immediately, the wind stopped and the lake became calm. Jesus asked His followers why they had been so afraid and wanted to know why they didn't have any faith. They didn't really say, but they did talk about how the wind and the waves obeyed Jesus that day. Jesus came to earth to show us that we can believe and trust in all of God's promises, like God's promise that He's in control of everything, even the wind and the waves, or about how He will watch over us and give us everything we need, and He'll forgive us and always love us. The devil doesn't want us to have faith in God, though. So he tries to throw lies and tricks at us to get us to stop believing in what God says. That's why God has given us the shield of faith. When we trust in every word God says to us, we'll be able to block anything the devil tries to send our way. We can hold up the shield of faith.
Shall I fear?
to be like the disciples in the boat with Jesus. They quickly forgot that Jesus would always care for them and protect them from the storm. I want to remind you that these disciples have been following Jesus around for quite a while, and they saw him perform many miracles with their own eyes. As well, the disciples literally were lying right beside Jesus, and yet they still managed to doubt and forget to trust in Jesus' protection. Before you judge the disciples for their lack of faith, I want to tell you how easy it is to forget or to doubt God's promises. Maybe you've already experienced that. This is why we have to hold up our shield of faith every day. We have to trust God all the time, and we have to train ourselves to do that for us to have the full confidence. God's promises you and me many things if we put our faith, also known as our trust, in him. What promises from God do you hold on to? Think about that. I want to highlight a few that I think are most reassuring for you. God always loves you, even when you do wrong. God does not expect you to be perfect. He loves you regardless. But because we're not perfect, God always forgives our sins when we confess them. We do need to confess our sins when we do wrong. But isn't it a wonderful promise that he always loves us even when we do wrong? God is always with you wherever you go. If he is with you wherever you go, you are never alone. If I'm never alone, I don't need to be afraid. I don't need to feel lost. What a wonderful promise that he is always with you wherever you go. God is always in control. You're kind of in a time that's very unusual. And last week, lots of things were happening in the world. Lots of people were scared and uncertain, and there was a lot of unrest. But in the midst of all that, it can easily feel like everything is out of control. But you can be assured that God is in control, even in the midst of that. He is taking care of you and taking care of this world at all times. God created you with a purpose, and he has a plan for your life. You are not a mistake. You have a purpose. Maybe you haven't yet completely discovered or realized what your purpose is, but I can guarantee you that you were created with a purpose. That is a promise from God. And you know, there are many, many more, but I want to end with this one. God's promises are steadfast. That means none of these promises change. They are always the same, yesterday, today, and forever. Using your shield of faith means you are putting your faith in God in all circumstances. Faith in God, boys and girls, is what gives you the confidence and allows you to stand strong, because you know he will take care of you, and you know that through him and because of him, you can and you will experience true love, true joy, true peace, and you always have hope. Each time you hold up your shield of faith, Satan is powerless. Well, I want to close by talking to God and then sing a song about how sweet it is to have faith or to trust in Jesus. Let's pray. Dear God, thank you for your many promises. How blessed we are to have the confidence and hope that you are always with us, that you always love us and forgive us, that you have a plan for my life, and that you never change. God, help us to hold up our shield of faith and to trust in your protection every day. May we stand strong and confident as a child of God. In your most worthy name, amen.